Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav from Automation Step by Step, and today we are going to see some really awesome free Appium AI tools by TestProject. And these tools and these features will help us to create more stable mobile tests. So let's get started, and today we are going to learn and see what are TestProject's AI tools, what are they and how will they help us, and then we are going to see a very interesting step-by-step demo. So with that, let's get started and let us see what are these free new AI tools, and then we will see a step-by-step demo. We have Adaptive Wait, Automation Assistant and Self-Healing. So these are the three new features and new tools. And before I dive deep and check all these tools and their functioning, let us first create our test. So step number one is we will first have to download the latest agent. You should be having the agent version 0.65.30 or later so that you can get all these tools. So I will first log into my TestProject account, and I have already done this. And if I go to the agents, here you can see I have my agent running on my Mac OS. Agent is started, and then step number two is we can create a new project or can use any existing project. Now if I go to my projects, and earlier I had created a project for mobile testing, let me just use this. If you want, you can create a new project, and then we can create a new test in the project. So before we create a new test, you should be having your mobile device connected so that we can start recording the test. And just in case you have any issues in connecting your mobile device or getting ready, you can check my video. If you go to my website automationstepbystep.com and you can scroll down and go to test project, this will take you to the test project YouTube playlist, and here you will find this video, how to do Android mobile testing. Here you can see all the steps, how you can set up and get the mobile ready for recording. So connect your mobile device, and then we will create and record a mobile test. So here I will go and click on new test, select mobile and say next. And here I will say new AI tools demo. You can give some description. Description is optional and tags are also optional, and say next. And here I'm going to use an Android device, and here you can either add some APK file or application file, or you can select the application from the mobile. So I'm going to use a calculator application and click on next, and I will say record and say start recording. So here it should connect to my mobile device, and you can see this is getting connected. And once this is ready, we will start our recording. You can also see here the first step is reset app. So if you always want to start a fresh app for recording, you can use this. So the same thing it is asking me here, do you want to reset the application? I will say yes. So that will become the first step. So you could see there was a calculator app already open, and now it is opening a fresh application. And now I can start recording. So let me say I click on 2 here, and this will record my step. The step is recorded here. Then I will click on plus, and I will click on 3, and then I will say equals. And now I have got 5 here. Now I want to validate that I have got the text 5 here. So I will highlight this element and press double shift, that is press shift 2 times, so that it brings up this window to add validations. I will go to validations and say contains text, and here you can see it has added the validation as a step here. And that's it. I will click on pause, and all my steps are recorded. Now once we have done the recording, now we can explore the new test project's AI features. The first one is adaptive wait. So here, if you go here to these three dots and click on settings, you will see here we have adaptive wait, and by default it is 1500 milliseconds, that is 15 seconds. Now I can change this. If you want to change this value, you can always change it from here and save this. So I have now made the adaptive wait as 20 seconds. And what exactly is this? Adaptive wait will wait for the application and the environment to be ready before doing the actions. And this is very important because this will help reduce test flakiness. Flakiness is when you record your test, it passes, and when you run it, it sometimes passes and sometimes fails. And this is because sometimes the elements are not ready or the environment is not ready, and therefore we can use adaptive wait to handle these kind of scenarios. Now it will wait up to the maximum threshold. For example, I have set 20 seconds here, so it will only wait for maximum of 20 seconds, but as soon as it finds everything is ready, the element is there and the application is ready, it will do the actions. So it will not slow down your application. So this is adaptive wait. Now we have automation assistant, and here again, if you see, we have this enable automation assistance here, and by default it is always enabled. If you can switch it off or on, and this again helps us a lot. It will analyze each step, and in case there is any step that does not meet or reach its goal, it will attempt to fix it automatically. So you can just make it enabled from here. And then we have self-healing, and self-healing is when you have any changes in your element locators. Sometimes your locators change from the backend when you get a new release, or sometimes we have dynamic locators that always change whenever you run your application. In this case, self-healing will work, and it will try to find the element using different locators, and it will help to reduce test failures. Let me show you this as well. And before I show you self-healing, let me just save this, and I will run this and check if everything is recorded properly. So it opens the application and it is executing all the steps, and looks, everything is fine. So you can see all the steps are done. Now let us say I go to this step, that is, it is finding this particular element and then checking the text contains 5. So I will go here, and you can see this is the element locator it is using, that is XPath. So I can click on this editor or edit button, and then here this is what it is using. I will change this. Let me say I will make some changes so that it fails, and then I will save this. And you can see this has changed here. Let me now try to run the test again and see what happens this time. I will click play. And this is all fine. And now you can see as soon as it comes here, it is not able to find. And also now you can see this text at the bottom. The expected element in step 6 is missing. Don't worry, TestProject's AI is looking for another path forward, and let us wait and see what happens. And yes, it was able to find the element, and here it is saying that TestProject AI found a better way to locate your element during recording, and here it is saying that this particular XPath or locator has failed, and this is what is now suggested. You can always cancel or confirm. I will say confirm. And now for the next time this will be used. So if you see here, if you go to the elements, there are a lot of locators recorded by TestProject whenever you record your test, and in case one of the locator fails, it will always find the element with a different locator if you have the new AI tools. And you can always add new locators or make any changes in the existing locators as well. So now let me try to run this. Also, if you see here, it is saying that this has now auto healed. If you go to the details, you can see details here. Let me now go and run this again. So I will click on play. And this is working. And yes, this time you can see it has now passed our step number 6 as well. So these are the 3 AI tools. Now along with this, adaptive wait, automation assistant, and self-healing, along with these 3, you can also set the execution speed as needed. So sometimes automation is very fast and your application is not able to cope up with the speed of automation. So you may need to slow down the execution of your test. So here you can go to the settings and you will find an option for execution speed, and you can always set it to fast, normal, slow, turtle slow, or custom. And if you set it from here, make sure that in any of the steps, if I go to any of the steps, you can see here as well, we have the execution speed. So this should be using the test default. Otherwise, it will override whatever you have set at the test case level. So with this, you can ensure that you have less failures and you have a more efficient testing. And then you can always add validation. So you can always go to any of the element and you can press double shift. And here you can add all the validations like is it visible, is it present, clickable, and all these validations so that it proceeds to the next step only when that particular element is present. So all this we can do, you can again press double shift to remove this window. So with all these AI tools and all these features, you can ensure that your tests are more stable, faster, it will reduce flakiness, it can take care of the dynamic elements, or in case there are any changes in the locators, if you get a new release of your application, and will make your overall process of mobile testing very easy and very efficient. And we have already done step number 6, that is run and check. And with this, we have learned all the new AI tools for mobile testing in TestProject and what are they and how do they help us. I hope this session was very useful for you. Please do share your knowledge with everyone and I will see you soon. Thank you for watching.